Hi guys, welcome to Twitter's funny channel. Today I'm going to teach point of sale system step by step part 41 tutorial. Here in our last tutorial I explained this stuff. Here when you execute the program, here you can notice that here this one will be, I explained in my last tutorial, but what is this one also here, name mean this is this column, the same name is taken here, name, this one also name, here this one also name, so that three name will be coming in the output. Okay, here go back to our coding view. Here the same coding I paste it here, something I like this, right. Here within the double quotation mark you have to paste this coding as you written earlier, the same coding you have to paste, this coding you have to paste here. You test it, it will be work properly. Here output will be coming, the same output I'm going to fill into my data grid view as output, so that I'm going to put in this things into my data adapter, the same coding within the double quotation. It successfully, after that the same thing, after that I am creating one data table subject DT, after that ADA mean this data adapter, I am filling this query, I am filling and put into this data tables, after that I am setting to data grid view, data grid view dot, there will be the predefined property which is a data source equal into, I set into this data table object into data grid view. What is the query here you written here, the same thing fill into, put into this DT and pass into DT, the output will be the same, output will be here, sorry, the same output will be fill into my data grid view, the same output will be fill into my data grid view. Okay, after that what I did here is each and every here, I let's comment this and explain, then you will easy to understand the stuff. Here if you click start here, sorry, I have to, when the form is loaded double click on this, this method will be loaded. Okay, you have to call the method within the form load. Okay, so I didn't make the connection for that, so go back to my main form here, let's delete this one. Which I put the demo button here. I'm going to create one button which is a stock. So go back to my toolbox and search the tool which is a picture box. This one will be, drag on your form, adjust the size, and you can browse the image. Okay, I'll put this one stock in here like this, click OK, set as here stretch image, it is fit on the screen. Okay, here I'm going to put here as a stock. Going to change the font size with bold change as 10 or 12 not 12 it's a size I gave for this 16 so let me change as 16 with bold okay perfect okay now let's run the tutorial and see what will be the output let me arrange them Now let me start the program here. Now if I click the stock if the links goes to the stock form I didn't link this one so what is the form name I'm going to link stock that will be my form name stock this one will be my form name which will be stock so double click here stock st equal new stock here I st dot that's the thing I'm going to do okay let's run and see then another important task I have to do is when the form is stock form is loaded here I didn't change the border also border style I'm going to change as none so it like this and here form color I'm going to change as the white color sorry some white color okay perfect if you want you can change the color of the data grid view also here background here default will be app workspace you can change the color what we want if you change as red it will be red you can change whatever color you need okay this one this is not a this one also you can change as a white okay let's execute the program and see what will be the output here but it's not loading at the center so click on the form and go to the properties here you have to select the starting point starting position you have to change as center screen and if you select and execute the program you can see it is coming at the center okay here now what I'm going to do is here this is coming like as a database thing output here coming now what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the row names if you come like this we can't find the actual name of what is the category what is the brand what is the product name it is very hard to find that so that what I'm going to do is here I'm going to write the query which is a data grid view dot column zero mean data grid view here this data grid view starting mean this item code will be zero category mean 1, 2, 3, 4th position 5th position there will be containing 5th position but always starting from zero keep in your mind not 1, 0 okay so here what I did is column zero header text mean header text I set as item item code column 1 I set as category column 2 I header text I set as brand column 3 header text I set as product column 4 header text I set as price column 5 header text I set as stock key this how we set the heading title here like this here this how you can set track this okay it's automatically changed okay you can see like this okay After that, I created one. We have to stop over here. I already drag one label control. Label control dot text default property equal into zero. I equal one thing is zero, some value is zero here. After that, I wrote one for loop. This which I did in, when I doing the report stuff. I explained this stuff earlier when I did the report stuff. I'm creating one variable I variable equal into zero. After that, data grid view dot count minus one bill one mean. It's counting each and the counting all the rows from the data grid view plus plus. Here I'm going to count only this row, data grid view rows I cell number 5. Cell number 5 mean this one. 0 1 2 3 4 5. So counting this one, counting mean this all are calculating and display the total. So that I wrote the query this one, how many rows available in the quantity, the all the one is calculating and adding into label text. Okay, how many columns you have a quantity, the all the records will be calculated one by one and at the final total will be passing to LBL text. Okay, so that you can get the final total of stock at the below like this. This all are calculated one by one, all together the final total will be displayed at the below like this. Okay, after that what I did is here okay, let's go back to our loading button. Double click on this one here. What I'm going to do is here also I'm going to write another query, copy this one, the same thing. I'm going to write another one here. I'm going to change the name as load btn mean button. This query will be load for the button. I write the same query here. What are the different is here, what we have to do is here when the page is loaded, the automatically this data grid view will be filling like this. Here you have to category wise you have to filter in the record, or brand view wise you have to filter in the record. You have to write the coding so that I write the coding here. That will be I explain that one. Same coding, what you have to do is here. Here, this is the last code adding. Here, I create one where category name will be this one. Sorry, this category name, what are the name you are typing here, and mean this one, this text box, this text box mean this text box, stock text box mean this text box one will be belongs to category, text box two will be belongs to brand. Okay, here where category name mean this category name what you are typing here on this text box. Okay, or mean if you put and, both conditions should be true, it will be work. This operators are belongs to or mean either this, so this will be correct, it will be work. Okay, so if you write this one as AC here, the what are the AC here if you select the here if you select as AC, here only one record, how many products AC it is showing the record into my grid view. It is filtering. What are the brand, if you select text box 2, the brand name will be showing. So that I put here brand, where category name also this one, brand name also you have to enter in text box 2. Okay, the appropriate record will be filtered. So that I put one where clause. Where clause mean will be the particular column will be taken, and what are the records available in that particular column it will be getting. Okay, so that I put where, in where clause I am putting two conditions here. One is a category, another one is a brand. Either this one true or this one true, it will be work. Okay, okay, let me check it here. What is the error? Okay, here some error. Okay, here I'm going to, okay, perfect. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to call this method into this button. This method mean this not sales, stock here, this button. After that I need one close this form, so that I put the close here for this button, cancel button. I need this form containing two buttons, one is a load, another is a cancel here, so that I wrote the coding for the cancel button here. Double click on here, this dot close mean this current form will be closed. Okay, let me test that if it is working or not. Click on this one, perfect. Now I want to filtering as a category wise, so AC, click load here, it will be loaded like this. So that I put the coding will be in the where clause. Where clause will be, it's selecting the row and selecting the appropriate record for the AC here. What are the category the AC will be belongs to, what is the project products and brands, so that it is displayed. You can brand wise also you can check here, IP new, you enter and load here, you can getting the record like this. It is easily we can filtering here, how many stock you can filtering here, how many stock available in this IP new brand, you can easily filtering like this. It's very easy way to filtering like this. So that I do this program. You must try this program, you can do it. Okay, if you have any doubts you can ask me anytime. Thank you for watching. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.